Good morning everybody. In this video, we will study what changes occurred to these tribal people in the medieval period and how these changes occurred. So that's why the topic is changing society, new castes and hierarchies. Now, in the medieval period, especially the whole society was divided into four castes, which is also called as Varna system. Now, there were many smaller castes also which started joining this Varna system, and so many new jatis emerged in this Varna system. Now, who were these jatis who started entering into the Varna system? Who were these new castes? So, it was the tribal people and many other social groups which were not following the caste-based society previously, but now they started entering the Varna system or the caste-based societies. So, many tribals and many other small groups also started joining the caste-based society. And these new groups which joined, they were given the status of jatis. And this was required because the society was undergoing changes. So, there were new economic groups or new type of people who were required, and the needs of the society grew, the economic needs also grew. So, accordingly, new groups were added into the caste-based society. So, as economy grew and the needs of the society grew, people with new skills were required, and these people with new skills were added in the caste-based society. Now, there were many people with practicing different skills, like there were smiths, there were goldsmiths, blacksmiths. So, these were the smiths. Then there were many carpenters, masons. They all were recognized as separate jatis and they were included in the caste-based societies, and their jatis became basis of the organization of the society. Now, apart from that, many new castes appeared in the Brahmanas also, many new jatis appeared in Brahmanas also. Then among Kshatriyas also many changes occurred, like new Rajput clans also started coming and they also started becoming powerful. In the 11th and 12th century, many Rajput clans became very powerful. Now, there were many Rajput clans which were living in India, like many Varunas, then Chandelas, Chalukyas, all these were the Rajputs. So, many of these were actually tribal people who converted themselves into caste-based societies. Some were tribes and many of these clans like Gunas, Chandelas, Chalukyas, they started recognizing themselves as Rajputs. Now, many of these Rajput rulers, they replaced the older rulers and they became new rulers. And when they started ruling over the country, so this gave an inspiration to the other tribal people, and they set an example from the for rural people. With support of the Brahmanas, many of these tribal people started converting themselves into Rajputs, and many of them joined the caste system. But the important thing is, those who joined the caste system and those who wanted to become rulers, they can only belong to a big family, that means big tribal family. So, there were many small families also, small tribal groups. So, these small tribal groups were included in the caste-based society, but they remained as the lower jatis. But the bigger and the influential tribal society or the tribal group, they became the Rajputs, and later on they became the rulers also. So, many joined the lower jatis and many tribes adopted Islam. Some of them do not want to join the Rajput clan, but they wanted to change into caste-based society or other society. They converted into Islam, but they were not ready to join Hinduism criticism because there were so much of distinction or upper caste, lower caste in Hinduism. So they converted themselves into Islam. Especially the tribal people of Punjab, Multan and Sindh, in these areas they converted into Muslim. And they rejected the caste system, and because the caste system was having unequal social order. So in this way we have seen that many new groups entered into the caste based society. Many of the tribal peoples also converted themselves into Kshatriyas, and for that they have to take the help of the Brahmanas. So by performing some yajna they converted themselves into Kshatriyas, about which we have already studied in 7th standard, second chapter, that is Hiranyagarbha and all. Now many of the big tribal societies, they converted themselves into large states. So emergence of large states among the tribal groups occurred because many social changes occurred in the tribal people. So we'll study about two such states which were tribal societies and converted themselves into big states. One is Gond Kingdom and one is Ahom Kingdom. So we'll study about that in the next video.